Strategies of Patikala College. Strategy implementation is a process of activating the strategy. It is the sum total of all the activities and choices required for the execution of a strategic plan. It is the process by which strategies and policies are put into action through the development of budgets, programs and procedures. So students, I, Krupa Shah, from Patikala College of Commerce and Management, is going to say something about behavioral and function implementation.
Behavioral implementation deals with those aspects of strategy implementation that have impact on the behavior of the people in the organization. Since an organization is basically a deliberate creation of human beings for certain specified objectives, the activities and behavior of its members need to be directed in a certain way. Any departure from this leads to inefficiency in the organization and consequent failure of strategy. There are five issues in this context relevant to strategy implementation: leadership, organizational culture, values and ethics, social responsibilities, and organizational politics. Let us deal these issues one by one. The first one is leadership. Effective leadership is required to lead and guide the subordinates to perform organizational tasks effectively. Leadership is the activity of influencing people to strive willingly for group objectives. Every manager develops a style of managing the activities. Such style varies from leader to leader, from situation to situation, and from organization to organization. Several researchers have made an attempt to identify the traits or qualities of effective and successful leaders. Successful leaders have interests, abilities, and personality traits that are different from those of less effective leaders. As per the research studies, some traits increase the likelihood of success as a leader, but none of the traits guarantee success. A great deal of training, experience, support from higher authorities is required to be an effective leader rather than merely possessing leadership trait. The second issue is organization culture or corporate culture. The organization culture affects the ability of the management to perform strategic management. Culture affects not only the way manager behaves within an organization, but also the decisions they take about the organization's relationship with its environment and its strategies. Culture is the strength that can also be the weakness. As a strength, culture can facilitate communications, correct decision making and control, and create cooperation and commitment. As a weakness, culture may obstruct the smooth implementation of strategy by creating resistance to change. The third aspect or issues is values and ethics. The value system is the attitude towards life and judgment of what is desirable and is very much a part of a person's personality and a group's morale. Business ethics relate to the study of how moral and social norms can be applied to activities and goals of a commercial enterprise. The twin issue of personal values and business ethics have come to occupy center stage in management. There is an increasing awareness around the world about ethical practices in business. A major task of leadership is to inculcate personal values and creating the sense of business ethics among the organizational members. The next issue is social responsibilities. The issue of social responsibility of business towards society should be considered in all phases of strategic management. For implementing social responsibilities, adequate funds are required to be allocated. Even specific positions and system for social responsibilities are to be created. Policies and procedures have to be formulated for an effective discharge of their social responsibility functions. The last issue is organizational politics and use of power. Organizational politics is concerned with the use of power and relates to managing coalitions, consensus building, and the creation of commitment to organizational purpose and mission. Generally, there is more politics in implementing strategy than in formulating it. In implementation, politics and power affect a number of elements such as consensus building, managing coalitions, creating commitments, conflict resolutions, balancing of interest, resource allocation, delegation of authorities and responsibilities, and so on. Experience has shown that by having an understanding of the use of politics and power, strategists can perform the task of strategic management better. Let us deal these issues one by one. The first one is leadership. Effective leadership is required to lead and guide the subordinates to perform organizational tasks effectively. Leadership is the activity of influencing people to strive willingly for group objectives. Every manager develops a style of managing the activities. Such style varies from leader to leader, from situation to situation, and from organization to organization. Several researchers have made an Luke has suggested 5 reasons to show why functional policy and plans are needed. Functional plans and policies are developed to ensure that the strategies, decisions are implemented by all part of an organization. There is a basic available for controlling activities in different functional areas of business. This time spent by functional managers on decision making may be reduced, or the plans lay down clearly what has to be done, and the policies provide the discretionary framework within which decisions need to be taken. Similar situations occurring in different functional areas are handled to the functional managers in a consistent manner. Coordination across the functions take place where necessary. This is the reason why functional strategies are required. The next issue is social responsibilities. The issue of social responsibility of business towards society should be considered in all phases of strategic management. For implementing social responsibilities, adequate funds are required to be allocated. Even specific positions and system for social responsibilities are to be created. Policies and procedures have to be formulated for an effective discharge of the social responsibility functions. The organizational plans and policy, it deals with 1. Production system, operational planning and control, research and development. So when we look into production system, it deals with capacity, location, layout, product or service, design, work system, degree of automation, extent of vertical integration. Operation of planning and control involves aggregate production planning, materials planning, inventory, cost and quality management, and maintenance of plant and equipment. If we look into research and development, it includes product development, personnel and facilities, level of technology used, technology transfer and absorption, technological collaboration and support. Financial plans and policy revolves around the following: the decisions pertaining to capital mix decisions, usage of funds, and management of funds. So when we look into capital mix decision, it involves capital structure, procurement of capital and working capital borrowings, reserves and surplus, relationship with lenders, banks and financial institutions. Usage of funds involves investment or asset mix decisions, capital investment, fixed asset acquisition,
current asset, loan and advances, dividend decisions, etc. Management of funds says the system of finance, accounting and budgeting, cash, credit and risk management, cost control and reduction, etc. Resources are the most important resources of an organization. The success of organization depends upon the quality of human resource. HR plans and policies deals with the following: personnel system, organizational and employees characteristics, and industry relations. Personnel system relates to manpower planning, selection, development, compensation, communication, and appraisal. For example, Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited created transparency in appraisal system, reduced transfers to encourage specialization, and developed effective communication system. Organization and employee characteristics involves corporate image, quality of manager, staff and workers, perception about the image of the organization as an employer, availability of development opportunity for employees, and working conditions. Whereas industrial relations involve union management relationship, collective bargaining, safety, welfare and security, employee satisfaction and morale. For example, Tata Steel Limited claims to have never had a major industrial relation problems for the last several decades. The prevalence of the congenial industrial relation environment is mainly attributed to the personnel plans and policies. Kluge has suggested 5 reasons to show why functional policy and plans are needed. Functional plans and policies are developed to ensure that the strategies
Thank you so much. Stay safe and be safe. Thank you.